It's Thursday, 8 p.m. The next episode of Grey's Anatomy is about to be aired. Will you tune in? Questions like this have been at the heart of television research for years. But today, what networks really want to know is whether social media, all those tweets, Facebook posts, and YouTube videos, whether this online social world we now live in is triggering you to watch.
It's not easy to tease apart the many influences on viewing, but in a groundbreaking collaboration between industry and academia, that's exactly what we set out to do. It's a research project unlike any you have seen, with important insight you won't want to miss. My name is Renana Peres, and I'm a professor of marketing at the Hebrew University in Jerusalem.
My name is Mitch Lovett, and I'm an associate professor at the University of Rochester Simon Business School. We collaborated with the Keller Fay Group, the Council for Research Excellence, and Nielsen. It was truly a marriage of industry savvy, research expertise, and academic rigor. We collected a representative sample of 1,665 respondents. For 21 days, they used a smartphone app to report on primetime TV programs they watched or saw, heard, or communicated something about.
During the study, we collected almost 200,000 reports about viewing and communicating about almost 3,000 shows. Then we linked this data to Nielsen PeopleMeter data, AdView's show promo data, and the Tribune broadcast schedule, so we can know exactly what people watched, what ads they saw, and what they could have watched.
We took this amazing and unique data set and applied state-of-the-art Bayesian statistical methods to analyze it. We estimated the relative impact of each kind of communication, from Twitter to Facebook posts to texting to lunch conversations. But we went much further. We examined breakouts by genre, demographics, super connectors, show loyalty, and new versus returning shows.
What did we find? Join us on Monday, June 15th at 12:40 at our session, and we will tell you all about it.